I was raised out on the farm. I call it Phillips Flats. And as I grew up, it was a big family of us. I had five brothers and four sisters. And I worked hard on the place there, trying to help my mother take care of the family. I done about all the cooking for all that family and all the washing on a little rub boat. But they all about gone now, and I miss them all. I love them all. And when I was a young teenager, we got the home farm, and we had the horses and cattle, and I did a lot of the milking, and sometimes they'd send me to town overnight. It was about, I don't have many miles, about 8 or 10 miles, I guess, maybe a little further than that. I used to ride the horse and get groceries. And I used to ride with my dad in the wagon, my mom to town to get groceries, me and my other little sisters and brothers. Have stir offs, and big crowd to come to stir offs, and we have a lot of fun. If we have the corn chickens, we'd have supper. We have a big crowd to the corn chickens, and we had a lot of fun. To get a red ear of corn, they can get to kiss a girl if we wanted to. Out there with them having fun. I had to help my mother make dumplings, chicken dumplings, all that kind of food. A lot of pork stuff to eat on through the wintertime. My dad would raise molasses to eat on. Had plenty to eat, what we'd raise.
How you bake plain? With Martha Quine.
Yes, ma'am.
Goodness gracious, good and light, Martha Quine.
Martha Quine.
How you bake better biscuits, cakes, and pie? Call Martha White, say fries and flour.
The one all purpose flour.
Martha White sells fries and flour, he's got a high ride.
Martha White.
baked bed of biscuits, cakes, and pie. Holding Martha White's say fries and flour.
The one-all-purpose flour.
Martha White's say fries and flour. Got hot rice.
This is the Paint Rock School. When I went to school over there, I have not been in the picture, but my brother is. Brother, two brothers, Willard and Reuben Phillips. And I don't know all the some little kids, Sison Jeffers. I don't know all of them. I went to Paint Rock School years ago.
Fond memory paints the scenes of other years, bring me their memories still, and bright amid those joyous scenes appear the schoolhouse on the hill.
My brother, my oldest brother, he bought an old Ford car. I remember he was driving it around and it wouldn't start. We had to push it to get it going. And we got pushing to get it going, it started in. I climbed, it was a convertible. I climbed over the back of it so I could ride in too.
Playing in all these fine ashes, you know, and they were cold on top. I thought they were. So I'm barefooted and waded out in them, burnt the bottom of my feet. I was running around the house singing. Mommy finally caught me and said what was wrong. And she found out I burnt my feet.
Yeah. Well, you know, I did the same thing.
Y'all were out there washing. Now, for some reason, you was making hot water, had a big old pot out there or something.
Yeah, Mommy boiled
White
clothes, I think, then.
And,
old people did that.
And I stepped in that ash pile. It's got, man, it burned.
Yeah, it burned. Did you run around the house singing?
I don't know if I did or not.
It was still hot.
You're in the washing cycle.
Yeah, and I was running around the house just singing, and saw something wrong. And it caught me and burned my face. We had a good life.
Oh, yeah.
Back then. We had all kinds of food. We had to work for it. Yeah. We had to get out in the field and the garden and work for it. And I remember the time that we always peeled peaches on the front porch. So Mommy would help us, and then she'd have to go in when we got a canning done enough for her to start cooking. Build a fire in that cook stove, and in the summertime.
Oh, man.
Start cooking and canning.
Canning peaches.
So while she was doing that, we were still on the porch.
Well,
they were good in the wintertime, though.
Especially with hot biscuits.
Oh, yeah.
Man, that was really...
And we
had them a lot. That was good.
Yeah, just go to the cellar and get half a gallon.
And Mom would always add a little bit of sugar to them, even though they were sweet to start with. She would add some sugar, and you would just break, you know, put the bread like you was putting gravy on the top of your biscuit.
Uh-huh.
You just cover it with them peaches. Man, they were so good.
Oh,
it was like eating peach cobbler for breakfast.
I believe we eat better than we do now.
Did you ever hoe corn?
Oh, yes, I love corn.
And dug potatoes. You've dug potatoes.
I didn't really have to dig potatoes.
Oh, you didn't get to dig
the potatoes? No. Yeah. I don't remember doing that. The boys got them, I guess.
Yeah.
But I hoed, and I helped plant the garden and all of that.
Yeah. It was fun. It wasn't no fun back then, but it...
No, it hot.
Yeah.
I remember being out there with Mommy one time, and she made her a bonnet. Women back then, older women wore bonnets. She had that bonnet on, and we had a straw hat. She put that straw hat on. I put it on, and it made it hotter.
Yeah.
That hat, like, burnt me up. I pulled it off. I don't want nothing on my head.
Right.
Well, tell me about sewing or anything like that. Did you make quilts and sew?
Oh, Mommy made a quilt every winter.
I thought so.
Yeah, every winter.
Yeah.
And that's when I got a little bigger, I sat down and helped her. And then when I got married, I started making quilts.
Yeah,
Mommy made all my dresses out of feed sacks.
Yeah.
Well, she made your own shirts, too.
I know. But the feed sacks was pretty good cloth, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, it was good as anything you go buy, and there were different colors and flowers. And,
yeah.
Yeah.
I can vaguely remember her doing stuff, you know.
Yeah.
It's real vague. It's on that old Singer sewing machine in there, and it had treadles on it, and she'd be working her feet and sewing at the same time, treadling that thing.
Oh, you gotta pedal it,
Yeah.
And that's what I've always sewed on.
Yeah.
They wasn't too many that rich.
I don't know.
We thought the ones that lived in town, but they might have had it worse than we did. They,
because
they didn't have that big garden to grow food.
I know. Yeah.
So you thought, well, they live uptown, you know.
Right.
But it might have been harder for them than it was for us.
Yeah, you can't never tell.
We just did a lot of work, but it didn't hurt us. Just the way it was back then, it didn't hurt us.
That's where you moved to when you got married, to a cabin down there at Cold Springs.
Yeah. It wasn't bad living at Cold Springs then. No. Two rooms all we had, the living room and bedroom was together, but then you had the long kitchen, but that was enough for us.
Yeah. Well, got married.
And the rent was $8 a month.
That's pretty high, huh? How are we going to pay the rent on that? I can hear it now.
Well,
I know money was tight back then, too. You didn't make a lot of money, did you?
But $8.
Yeah.
$8 a month. Yeah, Nick's Creek. Yeah, Nick's Creek was a school.
Yeah, how many rooms was it?
Three rooms.
Was there kids in all three rooms?
Three classes in each room.
Yeah, but I mean, all three rooms was being used?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it took them all because there was a lot of kids went to.
Yeah, Nick's Creek.
The country schools at then.
Yeah, that's where I started. Down. To the first and second.
Yeah, every little place had a little country school back then.
And before the bus started running around the Nick's Creek Road,
we walked out Frank's store and waited. Everybody's gathered at Frank's store waiting on the bus.
Oh, really?
And we got off out there and walked home in the evening.
It didn't come down here?
Mm-mm.
Oh. Well, now it did when I was
in school. Yeah, it did later, but it didn't for, I guess, 2-3 years maybe.
Yeah.
We'd have walk out Frank's.
Hmm.
But, you know, it was kind of fun back then. Everybody was walking. Everybody sang.
Yeah.
Now, did you play ball or anything?
Oh, yeah.
Did you play basketball?
I play basketball, yeah.
Did they have teams that played other schools? You played?
We had one team, yeah.
Yeah. Did you get to play on it?
Yeah.
Did you?
Mm-hmm.
In the basketball.
In the basketball. Yeah.
You ain't got a picture of that, had you? Oh, you needed a picture.
And they had the boys' team, too. Dallas was on the boys' team.
Yeah, and no picture of that.
Not that I know of.
Yeah, we'd walk over to Birchville from Nick's Creek, play them.
Yeah. You have a good team?
We won sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes we didn't.
That's normal.
But, yeah. And we didn't have, we played out in the dirt. We had dirt court.
Yeah.
And Birchfield did too.
So you didn't have a gym to play basketball?
Oh, no.
You was right out there in the elements.
It sure was.
If it rained, you didn't get to play.
No.
Yeah, it's too muddy. Well, that's all right.
And what was good about it, if you played schools that had their gym and stuff,
and they come there and they had to play on that, they weren't used to that, you know.
They weren't used to bouncing the basketball off rocks and stuff. That you guys knew where every little hump in the dirt was, I bet.
Well, it didn't have any rocks on it, best I remember.
Yeah.
It was smooth.
Packed down.
Yeah.